Hello, I am SeamusDonohueEVE University, and this is episode 19 of How to Survive EVE Online. In this episode, we are going to handle the next step in the industry chain. So go to Journal, Making Mountains and Molehills, right-click, start conversation with Hoover. And he wants us to build one unit of civilian Galente shuttle. Now, this is not something we can buy off the market, because if you right-click it, there's no view market details. You go to the market, you try to type in civilian Galente shuttle, there's no such thing. So no shortcuts here. You're going to have to build this thing. So, first of all, we're going to need some tritanium. And I am short some tritanium, so let me refine the extra Veldspar I've got lying around into tritanium. Okay, good, now I have enough. So, click accept. Yes, you want to accept the mission anyway. Under ideal circumstances, you're going to build this in station. So, go to the blueprint, go to manufacturing, pick an installation, or not. You could, if you wanted to, queue up your job in an assembly line that's busy, and your job will be delayed by however much time the previous job needs to complete. I'm not going to do that. Let's cancel. Let's load the blueprint aboard. How much titanium will I need? 3,167. Okay. Left-click the titanium, then shift left-click and drag, then 3,167, push return, and let's undock. I'm going to lose say. Now, if you forgot which station actually has manufacturing slots open, you go to Science and Industry, Installations tab, Range.
Skill training completed.
Ah, cybernetics is done. Good. Luce 6, Moon 1, Federation Customs Assembly Plant. Alright. So there's Luce 6, Moon 1, Federation Customs Assembly Plant, and I hit dock. And my ship will go travel faster than light to that station before trying to dock up. Because strangely enough, you can't dock in a station that's 9 astronomical units away from you. Go figure.
Docking request accepted.
Alright, now I'm in station. Move over the blueprint, move over the titanium, right-click the blueprint, manufacturing, pick an installation, double-click an assembly line, push OK, accepts the quote. A packaged shuttle is 500 cubic meters. I'm not carrying that back with me. But there is another trick that I can do. So, while this job is in the works, I'm going to return to Clelanon and get out of my Navitas. Remember the first time you undocked from a station? You were in a capsule. And you went and picked up your very first ship.
Warp drive active.
And your capsule went inside the ship. Ever since then, you've just been swapping your capsule back and forth between ships. Well, you can get your capsule out of a ship again. And that's what I'm gonna do.
Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
Alright, I am in station. I'm going to right-click the Navitas and select Leave Ship. Please wait while ship is entering hangar. 13 seconds left. Oh, that reminds me. Push Escape. Go to the General Settings tab, Show Session Change Timer. That's over here on the left-hand side, second option from the top. Show Session Change Timer. and I will explain what that is. Let's right-click the Navitas again, leave ship, and you will see this spinny thing next to the solar system name. That's a session change timer. There are a number of things that cause session change timers, and session change timers cannot occur too close to each other. Changing ships, docking a station, undocking from a station, jumping through a stargate, joining a fleet, leaving a fleet, being promoted to a commander in a fleet, being demoted from commander in a fleet, being rearranged elsewhere in the fleet hierarchy, those are all session change timers. So if you join a fleet just as you're about to land on the stargate, congratulations, you can't jump through that stargate for 30 seconds. If somebody's chasing you in low security space, that's bad. So you'll want to show the session change timer, and you can mouse over it to see the tooltip to see how many seconds are remaining. Very important to keep that in mind. By the time I drop out of warp, the session change timer from undocking has passed, and I can just jump through the stargate pretty easily. There are some stargates and stations that are in orbit around the same planet, so if you leave the station and warp to the stargate, it'll have been less than 30 seconds, and you have to wait before jumping through the stargate. I'm going to head to Luce 6 Moon 1, Federation Customs Assembly Plant. Let me go to Science and Industry, let me go to the Jobs tab, and the shuttle is ready, so I'm going to click Deliver. You are 0 jumps away from this installation, you lack the required supply chain management skill. Ah, yes. If you want a job delivered, by default, you have to be in station. If you want to have the job delivered even though you're not physically present, you need a skill in the industry category called supply chain management. I don't have that skill yet, so I've actually got to dock up before I can tell them to deliver this.
Docking request accepted.
And I docked in a station where I did not have a ship already, so the game creates a noob ship for me. I don't need another one. I'm gonna repackage it, and I'm gonna trash it. Science and Industry, get jobs, click the job, deliver, close this. Right-click the shuttle, assemble it. Right-click it again, make active, double-click it. You know what? I'm gonna carry this stuff. You know what? Alright, I've cleaned up my assets. Undocking. Stargate Clolonon, warp to 0.
Warp drive active.
Alright, I am docked up in station. I'm just waiting for the session change timer to clear so I can get out of this ship. Strangely enough, the agent will not take the ship while I am still sitting in it. Go figure. Right-click the Navitas, make active, right-click the civilian Galente shuttle, repackage, and make sure you selected repackage, not trash item. Right-click Hoover Nair, start conversation, complete the mission, and in the next episode, I will take on the next step of the industry chain. I'll probably also explain implants at that time. In the meantime, thank you for watching.